Manhattan, New York. Ante la ausencia de regulación y fiscalización a los megabancos, y frente a una presunta colusión para transferir riqueza desde las clases baja y media hacia la élite, por parte de funcionarios del gobierno y del Banco de la Reserva Federal, los integrantes de la acampada de Occupy Wall Street, New York, montaron un juicio popular a Goldman Sachs. El destacado periodista Chris Hedge leyó un pequeño resumen de los supuestos crímenes cometidos por este megabanco, que según muchos controla no solo puestos claves de decisión dentro del gobierno estadounidense, sino de organismos multilaterales y gobiernos alrededor de todo el planeta. A decir de algunos, Goldman Sachs gobierna el mundo.
I would say this to everybody who's watching this. This economic crisis is like a cancer. If you just wait and wait thinking this is going to go away, just like a cancer, it's going to grow and it's going to be too late. What I would say to everybody is get prepared. This is not a time right now to wishful thinking the government is going to sort things out. The governments don't rule the world. Goldman Sachs rules the world.
Goldman Sachs, which received more subsidies and bailout-related funds than any other investment bank because the Federal Reserve permitted it to become a bank-holding company under its emergency situation, has used billions in taxpayer money to enrich itself and reward its top executives. It handed its senior employees a staggering $18 billion in 2009, $16 billion in 2010, and looks set to hand out $10 billion in mega bonuses in 2011. This massive transference of wealth upwards by the Bush and Obama administrations, now estimated at a staggering $13 to $14 trillion, went into the pockets of those who carried out fraud and criminal activity rather than the victims who lost their jobs, some of whom we'll hear today, their savings, and often their homes. Goldman Sachs commodities index is the most heavily traded in the world. The company hoards rice, wheat, corn, sugar, and livestock, and jacks up commodity prices around the globe so that poor families can no longer afford basic staples and many literally starve. Goldman Sachs is able to carry out its malfeasance at home and in global markets because it has former officials filtered throughout the government and lavishly funds compliant politicians, including Barack Obama, who received $1 million from employees at Goldman Sachs in 2008 when he ran for president. These politicians, in return, permit Goldman Sachs to ignore security laws that, under a functioning judiciary system, would see the firm indicted for felony fraud. Or, as in the case of Bill Clinton, these politicians pass laws such as the 2000 Commodity Futures Modernization Act, which effectively removed all oversight and outside control over the speculation in commodities, one of the major reasons food prices around the world have soared. In 2008 and 2010, prices for crops such as rice, wheat, and corn doubled or tripled, making life precarious for hundreds of millions of people. And it was all done so a few corporate oligarchs, the 1%, could amass personal fortunes in the tens of millions and often hundreds of millions of dollars.
Después de escuchar más testimonios, la Asamblea General de Occupy Wall Street deliberó en pleno y declaró culpable de crímenes financieros y de lesa humanidad al banco de inversión Goldman Sachs. Entonces se organizó una marcha para entregar el veredicto de este juicio popular en las oficinas principales de una de las más grandes compañías del planeta. Cabe destacar que son tan contundentes las evidencias contra Goldman Sachs que llama la atención el hecho de que el propio gobierno norteamericano no ha logrado o querido poner a esta compañía en orden. Los jueces y jurados que, ejerciendo su derecho de exigir reparos de asamblea y libertad de expresión, previstos en la primera enmienda de la Constitución,
trataban de obtener justicia en nombre del pueblo norteamericano y del mundo. Irónicamente, fueron los arrestados por la policía, que defendió los intereses de aquellos que a todas luces necesitan enfrentar a la justicia. Reportando para Telesur, yo soy Oscar León, el reportero del Sur.